Or J Dog ETG Paybacks coming at you with a Star Wars Galaxy Heroes video. I'm just gonna be having some Galactic War fun, GW fun, with my Gear 13s and the squads that go with them. And I might quickly run through my Gear 13s, but it's basically just some good old fashioned GW fun, clearing the thing. Please like and sub and share. The most important things are the likes. I don't care about the notifications, although that would be nice if someone cared as much. But the subscribers, the likes, the views, I'm not monetized. So, you know, that's literally like freaking charity for me. So, please like, view, as even if it's just for 30 seconds, as many videos as you can, or uploads as you can. So, anyways. Now I did these so I could make a command shuttle, my two favorite ships, the TIE Silencer and the command shuttle, extremely powerful. Some crew has a unique Gear 15, and he has a relic level 6, which made his TIE Silencer 75,777. Okay. 75. Okay. And then Kylo Ren, relic level 4, and then relic level 5. As I say, the special. And Captain Phasma, relic level 5, as I say, the special. Both making the command shuttle almost 60k, 69. Okay, almost 70k, 69k. So this one has 75,777 with 3 Omegas, purple beads, and 2 Zetas on that crew member. This one has 2 out of 3 Zetas, but it has 5 out of 5 Omegas. It's purple beads, and 2 of the 3 people are Gear 13 with Zeta each. Kylo Ren and Mads has a lead, being unique. Kylo Ren has a special. Captain Phasma has a lead. Sir, lead. Alright, well, it's Zeta. Outrageous is Zeta, the special. And Merciless Mercy lead. And Scar lead. I got the TIE Fighter pilot, Stormtrooper, the officer, Gear 11, and then a Gear 12 plus 4, the Special Forces TIE Fighter pilot, and the Executioner. This is pretty powerful too. My resistance, I have I've got a Gear 13, Jedi Training Ray, Relic Level 4, with a Zeta Lead and 2 Zeta Uniques. Then I've got Gear 12 plus 1, with 2 Zeta C3PO, a Gear 12 plus 4 with 2 Zeta BB-8. Gear 12 plus four with two Zeta Arctic E2, and then single Zeta G12-3 for Scavenger, and then G12 Finn, G12 Trooper, and everybody else is so no good. But they're all 7 stars except for Rose and Holdo. She's going to have the lead to the Uniques, Gear 15, Rail Clone 4. Commander Skywalker has the lead to the Uniques, Gear 15, Rail Clone 4. Same thing as Ray, G13, like level 4, let's just say the lead in 2 units. And then, C3PO, 2 Zetas, R2D2 with 2 Zetas, Chewbacca with 2 Zetas. C3PO, G12+1, R2D12+4, Chewbacca G12+3, Han Solo G12+3, 2 Zetas on Chewbacca, 1 Zeta on Han Solo, 2 on R2D2 on C3PO, 1 Zeta on Jyn Erso, 1 Zeta on Ahsoka Tano and Fulcrum, 1 Zeta on Captain Han Solo, 1 Zeta on Rebel Officer Organa, of Gear 12, and then Gear 12 by North Vegas, Beas Malbus, and Shuri Emma, the Hyder Pride Cherries, once in the day, and then with North Vegas, at Gear 12, and Ben, and they probably stand at Gear 11, and it's going downhill. Still alive, both of T3M4s. I don't have Candorous or those. I've got 3 on Jedi Knight Revan, 1 on Vasta, 1 on Jolie, 1 on Juhani, 1 on Mission, 1 on Zalbar, 1 on Karth. Anyways, but we're just showing the Gear 13 ones. So Jedi Knight Revan, Gear 13, Revan Combo 4. Gear 13, Relico 4, Zeta Special Lead and Unique, that's Bush on. Gear 13, Relico 4, Zeta Lead, Julie Bindo. G13, Rogue 4, Zeta Special, Juhani, G13, Rogue 4, Zeta Unique, to Sith Empire, but Darth Revan, Zeta Lead, 2 Zeta Uniques, could redeem Relic level 7. And then also with 2 Zidi, also with his Zidi name. Best Flesh on the Fallen gives 18 Relic level 7. With 2 Zidi uniques. Year 13, Relic level 5, Death Malik. With 2 Zidi uniques, Gear 13, Relic level 4, HP 47, and then Gear 12, Sith Trooper, and Gear 11, Sith Assassin, and then Gear 11, Sith Marauder. But to keep the KOTOR thing going. Best Sith, Darth Revan, Best Flesh on the Fallen, Malik, Treya, Dooku, Sion, Maris, Vader, Palpatine, Sith Trooper. With that Zeta Dooku, a Gear 12 Zeta Ventress, a Gear 11 General Grievous, a Gear 9 Newt Gunray, and a Gear 8 B2 Battle Droid. I was able to get Padme at 7 stars. Actually, I didn't even have the Zeta on Ventress at the time. Okay, so first, let's start with the That's my Raylo squad. Let's just show you how effective they are, and I'll show you in a little close up. I'm gonna start doing this from now on. So that's 3, 8, 11, 8 is on that. 2, 3, 13, 1, 11, 4, 1, 6. These 8 are going to have them off the table. And there's only 3 zeros, 4 people with 2 zeros. get two resistance, one rebel, and two rebel, galactic republic, rebel, and resistance. So, the rebel, and the resistance, republic. Has synergy with the other, the two resistances, or source energy with the Republic, Rebel, and Resistance people. So, Jedi Training Ray, BB-8, R2-C3PO have synergy, and then C3PO, R2-CLS have synergy. Synergy is going to be between so three, four people here who wield lightsabers. One is neutral light, the other two are light, and one is dark. But no Jedi or no Sith. We've got the lightsaber wielding Jedi in training, Luke Skywalker. The blue trade of the Jedi Knight Guardian. And then you've got Ahsoka Tano, the former Jedi Knight. So you've got Luke Skywalker. Notice how even though he talks about being a Jedi like his father before him, Commander Luke Skywalker carries a blue blade that used to belong to Anakin Skywalker. It's a weapon of a Jedi Knight Guardian, and he also, since he's not a true Jedi Knight yet, it's just listed as Rebel. He has the DL-44 heavy duty blaster pistol strapped to his side, along with the blue-bladed lightsaber. And then a former Jedi Knight trained by his father, Anakin Skywalker, Ahsoka Tano. Luke sees it as one leading to uniques, but Ahsoka Tano Fulcrum gives Luke's gear 15, Grogu for Ahsoka's gear for 12, that plus 3. And she has a Zeta special, and she carries two silver bladed. Lightsabers, both of them have a slightly different health. One's two-thirds the size of the other, known as the lightsaber Shoto. And although they are just both blades are just as powerful as the other, use the same type of crystal that was once red, and she healed it of its dark side bleeding. She caused the bleeding to reverse the bleeding process, and the blade reverted to white, so it'll never take its blue, gold, or green tone again, but it's no longer red, and it's bonded to her as if it was the crystal she used in her green blades or her blue blades. One is a standard size lightsaber, and the other is an identical version of that one, with hilt 2/3 the size, and a blade 2/3 the length. It just, although she doesn't even have a blaster, it's just wielding twin lightsabers. It looks very, looks very distinguished. She doesn't even say Jedi, it just says Rebel, just like Luke. There's another light side. I think I'm gonna have lights in the red and Rebel. And this one is not trying to be a Jedi, she used to be a Jedi. And then in the same animation, Grand Admiral Thrawn, in his white Grand Admiral's uniform, he might not have a force, but he's got a hulking frame and a genius tactical strategy, with genius tactical strategy. And then Rey Jedi training, although she says this resistance, she carries a sand-blooded lightsaber that Luke did belong to his father and his Skywalker. She's also gifted to the Royal Cobalt. So I was K12+3. It was really unique. So I got a bit of special CLS had a leading two uniques. Rey has a leading two uniques. And like CLS, she's a Royal Cobalt 4 gear 13. And they both have the same lightsaber. Although it says there's Luke's and then it's listed as Rey's, and under Anakin it'll be the same one. Anyways, she's either carrying an empty holster, she's wearing the empty holster that contained the small molded blaster that Han Solo gave her that she threw through the wall. On Octo, she's still wearing a belt. Or maybe it's a rooted one, and she may use it as a primitive lightsaber sling, but either way, the only weapon she's armed with is the blue blade lightsaber. So unlike Luke, she's reliant completely on the force power and a lightsaber for combat. But just as resistance from Jedi. And then the final one, and these are all stable lightsabers with a cylindrical design, except for the slight curve and Ahsoka's tilt. And then the totally divergent from the other ones, dressed in all black. A weave tunic, pants, a thick armored belt, and a long flowing cloak without its helmet or a cowl. Kylo Ren unmasked, the scar showing, and his new matte black lightsaber hilt that's more durable and more technologically advanced, making it giving him access to the cracked crystal that creates the bloodshine unstable crossguard lightsaber blade. The crossguard lightsaber hilt having a single blade and then two smaller edges of the crossguard, like a medieval style sword, acting as vents because his crystal is cracked. So he carries, the reason it was cracked is because he's not a Sith, he might be the grandson of a Sith. His relic is level 6. When he bled his crystal, he didn't have the tutelage, so it was cracked, and he created a hilt that would, in a regular hilt, that crystal would just blow up because the energy would be just exploding out of it, and instead of just going right out the top, it would blow it right up, so he needed one where the crystal, the energy had more places to go than just one. And so that's why I see when he does it, all three don't come at points the main blade does, and then the other ones do like vents. See? There's a delayed reaction there. And it's because the crystal ignites, comes at the run part, and then tries to go anywhere else, and it has a place to go out either side. So there are cross gray lightsabers that are stable and have regular blades. All three blades ignite at once. These ignite separately because they're acting both as cross gray emitters and as exhaust. But this hilt is not only more durable and technologically sophisticated, he has easy access to the cracked crystal to make adjustments in the field, as well as it being lightsaber resistant, made of black oak and Kratosis alloy, made of Frick alloy. Black oak casing, making it lightsaber resistant, and completely matte black. Crazy team, man. You've got Resistance, First Order, Empire, Rebel. We've got Rebel, Empire, Resistance, First Order. Do it one more time. Just to prove it was enough proof that it holds up against better teams. So, how many people are those lightsabers that are generating Sith? There's Grievous, Kylo Ren, Mask, space is smaller. These are smaller. Fulcrum. Ray. CLS. Get a closer look at them. Thanks, this is the last match. Please like and sub. And remember, even if you're not like totally blown away by the meager upload they do, please try to get as many as possible. Views and likes are like gold to me. Thank you very much, and have a great day wherever you are. May force be motherfucking with ya. Last one's gonna be a lightsaber fest, like a rave. It's gonna look like a rave. Like your 13. Is it elite? Is it unique? Star 7. Is this Crimson Blade? Your 13. Level 7. Unique, and the Saber Stealth with two Crimson Blades, best vision of Bond, and then Gear 13, Level 5 for two Zeta Uniques, and the Crimson Blade Saber, just like Darth Revan, Darth Malak. Gear 13, relic level 7. Certain Zeta lead, two Zeta uniques, with a crimson bladed, and a bigger ribbon. That was level 7. Zeta unique, first Zeta staff, the two Crimson Light Zeta blades, first Zeta shown the fallen. And then, at Gear 13, relic level 5, the two Zeta uniques. Was a pair. The Crimson Blade lightsabers was identical pair of Crimson Blade lightsabers. Blade, size, color, type, crystal, and hilt. Sith Marauder. And then, that's Gear 11. There's a famous stack for those two Crimson Blades. Sith Assassin. I dropped the HK and instead of the trooper, I started to use some water and air gas. So there's Revan with one blade, Malak with one blade, Bastila with two, Assassin with two, and then Marauder with two. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 blades with 7 people. So you got just over another. Remember, please like and view as many uploads as possible. It's like literally charity. You're helping me more than you know.